Hello, folks, and welcome back. Yeah, baby, climb that hill. Climb it. Woo. So, this is a hell of a lot better than that god-awful MSSV rover I tried to build. This is a jump capable, and I wouldn't recommend it for extended flights because of the wheel jitter bug that there currently exists. And why are you having sim speed issues? Come on, stop it. This thing's not even that complex. Anyway, this is a big rover that I built, and I need to drop the strength. That's upping it. There we go. Now we're dropping it. Alright, so I need to get down to the lake bed. So, anyway, yeah, I built this thing. And, whoa. Well, wrong way. Little gyro assist so we go over the rock instead of hitting our suspension, but we still hit it anyway. Hopefully it didn't take any damage. I can't see for everything else in a way. Huh. Clear any other rock but that one. Fine. I'll just shake loose. Back to third person view. Continue to gyro assist. Come on. Come on. Come on. There we go. You want to climb. You like climbing. While you're a large basin, you're a crawler, you are a climbing monster. And that's before we throw in anything like the assist. Oh yeah, baby. Alright, well, I already brought my buggy down to the lake. But we'll park on top of it, basically, as a size comparison. In fact, we'll just cheat and do the gyro assist to spin this thing around. Won't actually literally park physically on top of it, but we will park so that way it's underneath. Need to work on the almost had a rotor explosion. So yeah, you get an idea of the size of this thing. In it, this is small for a big ship truck. I tried using 5x5s, but I kept having desync issues and things exploding off of, the wheels exploding off of it at odd moments. So yeah, no on the just no. And we'll need that, and we'll need a rotor. That's a start for basic systems. We will need a flight seat, a battery, and we'll drop a reactor later. And in fact, we're going to be integrating the ore detector into the body, but not quite yet. Alright, so new large ship. We're going to be building not quite as fancy as this one. It's going to be a straight body as opposed to the fancy beveled edges that I have here. You know, you're not going to have the fancy beveled edges and everything. It's going to be a straight body instead, but it'll have identical performance. So, what we want to do is... come on. firstly, too wide. Secondly, alright, so there's our straight body. Or it would be a straight body. Because I placed the landing gear wrong, so we've got to add one more here and take it off here. There we go. Right. 1, 2, 3. Between. 2, 3. Between. 1, 2, 3. Between. All right. And that gives us actually one extra we don't need. Well, not off the backside at least. We might add it back on, depending on what we're doing. But this right here is the absolute most basic frame. Keep in mind, if you try to drive it empty like this, even after you've gotten the suspension tuned, it will be practically uncontrollable. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we want 1 and 5 to be paired, 2 and 6 to be paired, 3 and 7, and 4 and 8. The reasons for this will become known in a bit. Now, off the front, we'll need to... Actually, before we do any of that, we're going to be dropping... We'll drop it... right there, actually. That's a good spot. We're going to group the wheels and set the global suspension settings. Alright, so power, you want that around 17-18% to start with. Your friction down around 20. Your damping, I like that around 33 here for this setup. And the strength, initially, keep it around 70. Keep your height offset at negative 1.5. However, for right now, leave it stock because it's a little off the ground, and you want, when you cut off this landing gear here, you know, the thing not to shoot straight up in the air because, you know. Right, now we're sitting. Now we can finish adjusting our wheel suspension settings. We'll go for the maximum height offset so you've got the best ground clearance. Now, as I said, 1 and 5 need to be the same. 2 and 6 need to be the same, and we're dropping the steering ratio to 12 degrees. I'm still tuning this in, a little bit so that we get, you know, the optimum out of it. But under load, this seems to be pretty close. 10 for 3 and 6, and then these just drop 2 degrees to 18. The idea is to... And we'll go external view, and we need a battery, actually. So we'll drop a battery on here real quick. Alright. So, engage the parking brake. The idea is to have the outermost wheels with the more aggressive turn rates, the innermost wheels to have lesser turn rates, and the rear wheels to have less than the front wheel analogs. So the, you know, front's on 18, 12, 10, and 16. Alright, we'll leave the handbrake on. And start construction. We will be needing lights because this is going to be an industrial rover. And we'll be mounting more later for the sides, but not at this point. We're going to be dropping lights right here. And here. Now, I don't know why I put all this on here, but we were not going to need all of that real right now. We're going to be grabbing that and that. All three of those, an oxygen generator, a med bay, whoop, wrong. Oxygen generator, med bay, and We'll grab both large and small cargo containers. Now, what I'm going to be doing was actually be somewhat controversial to some people, and I really don't care. I'm going to be dropping that on there as such, and then but we're just trying to save some space here. And they mesh in just fine. Alright, next up we're going to be dropping in our assembler. And we're actually going to be doing the same thing here. Productivity module. We're only going to be putting one assembler on this thing, so we want it to be as efficient as possible. Alright, now the assembler will, I think, no, nothing, it won't mesh, so we've got to have a little bit of space here. Well, what we'll do back here is actually small cargo containers. That'll save us some space. We won't have the big one clogging up everything. We can drop the medical center, because this is a mobile base. Drop the med bay right there. Direct feed and more cargo. There we go. We're done. Now, right back in the back, right in the middle, we can drop a pair of gyros. We could do gyroscope assist. And we don't need any of these anymore. So, we are going to be dropping our ore detector because this is a mobile base. And what are you going to do with a mobile base? Well, run around with it. So you need an ore detector. Why did my dampeners turn off? Did I turn them off? I don't recall turning them off. I really don't care at this point. Okie dokie. The last thing we will need is something that is not solar to charge the batteries off of. So we'll drop on a single small reactor. Now, where I'm going to assume that we probably have a small mining drone. So we'll grab one real quick and we'll actually paste it in. Spoilers for something else. Actually, a better spot is, well, that would be up to you, really. I like having my driver's seat there, so. Alright, so we are going to be dropping yet another cargo container, because you can never have enough cargo. And then we're going to plop a connector onto the end of that, and we'll have something to hook the mining drone up to. Because of the orientation of it, I'm going to be taking the med bay and shuffling it over so that way we have more space and we won't be smacking into the med bay with the mining drone. There we go. We've got the basics. We've got everything set. This thing's actually ready right now to go out and be a basic prospecting ship, but it's not enough. You're not going to have any kind of terrain assist. You're literally just going to have to pick and choose your way around your terrain. So we want an antenna, the small jet engine, of course, the big engine, We're going to grab some small interior turrets because those are going to be your primary defense against cyber hounds. We're going to want a rotor for a ramp. We're going to need a landing gear. The first thing we're going to install is the engines as such. Bam. Seat is sitting right over where the engine thruster is going to be, but we can worry about uninstalling and reinstalling a new one later. Now, here's the problem with what I just did here. I'm going to be losing one of the effectiveness modules. So it's not going to be quite as effective or as it would have been. So do we want to sacrifice effectiveness, or do we want to sacrifice productivity? I don't know. That's completely up to you. And I also made another mistake here. I didn't put the ore detector far enough back. So there's one of our three primary aft-facing thrusters. For giggles' sakes, I'm actually going to put them lower as opposed to up high on that model there. And we'll worry about the rear-facing ones. I'm going to be mounting them up high on the front on the new model anyway. So, next stage, up front here because of where the engines sit here. We've got more of the basics in. We need our reverse thrusters. Because, as we all know, that's not going to be enough. And, yeah, this thing is nowhere near as pretty as, you know, the other one over there. Anyway, I'm going to drop a catwalk straight down here, down the middle. Done, and that should give plenty for the be a little tricky to maneuver your mining drone in underneath the catwalk and around to the pillar there, but it should work. Alternatively, you can do one of these numbers, cross-strut the pillar, and then delete the front portion. And that'll make it easier for you to get the mining drone in and out. Now, next part of what we need to do is way that's going to hold together for now, but we need that there, and we're going to be placing a rotor there so that way we can build our ramp. Alright, so I just got rid of the rotor. I'm going to be using heavy armor slope blocks, heavy armor blocks, and then some catwalk bits. So the rotor, I'm going to make sure zero is facing up. Drop my first block there. Go over two. Do that. One there. And then over here, seat back on, and for our rotor we will set the braking torque to max. Our lower limit, what is our lower limit? Probably a bit much. Oh yeah, that's a bit much. Is it the thrusters doing that? I need to grip the thrusters. Let's group the thrusters. There we go. And on, actually we're going to place that on hotbar 2 instead. So rotor reverse. Next up, landing gear, because we're going to have to switch lock on the landing gear all the time. Every time you engage the parking brake, you're going to have to switch lock on the landing gear again. And we'll drop the lifter engines here, lock on, off. And we're still not done. There's one more thing we need to actually install. One more thing, and I forgot all about it. So you don't have to leave your base here. You can go control your mining drone. Done. Nice open deck, decent expandability, and for whatever reason, it needs repair. Alright, well, let's go down here and really look real quick. Alright, so this could be probably another block long. Do, 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 do. reverse it. Attach it and then re-reverse it and just let it drop. One and two. Benefit to having heavy armor too is the fact that, frankly, it'll soak up. It lifts the thing. I need to play with the angle, but yeah, it's ready, I think, for the most part. Rotor. We will make it 330 then. Another 10 degrees, let's see, how far off the ground will you be? Too far, okay, maybe 225 or 325. That's just about right. Alright, let's get the catwalks on. For the various definitions of catwalks we shall need. Alright. Gotta have safety rails. For every place that we can't have safety rails, we need safety rails. Alright. Let's bring the ramp back up, and you can make it whatever speed you want. I like mine being a little slow. And that threatens to damage something, so I need to adjust the displacement of the rotor just a tiny bit, maybe. Don't want it smacking into something, come on. So what are we hitting that, because it's got to be hitting something. That should probably solve it. Let's see. Yeah, that solved it. Alright, so I think this thing's mostly ready. It's a new functioning base, a little more blocky, a lot less pretty, not that I think you could call this thing pretty, a lot more blocky, a lot less pretty than this model here, and as you can see it does have a slightly different arrangement, but it's got all the same components and batteries, which I forgot for whatever reason. So we'll just throw a couple of batteries right here, and that'll solve a lot of the power issues that it may or may not end up having. And actually, we will drop another three batteries there, and that'll definitely give it more than enough power, the reactors, just to supplement them. Or supplement the solars in recharging it. Last thing I would need to do is throw some interior turrets on to defend it against cyberhounds if you've got those enabled on your world. Pain in the ass, yes I know, but yeah. There we go. Very basic. Feel free to pause as you're going your way through. If you want to place the rear module in a different orientation, like I did over here, feel free. It's, you know, the reasons are being are very similar. You know, I built this one in survival myself. I actually dropped the refinery off on its side, and as opposed to set with this minimal equipment down here, and there's still a fair amount, but it's minimal equipment. In fact, something if you feel like you can actually manage it is, you know, cut off and leave a landing gear flush. So that way, if you've got a small rover like this, you give it a set of jump jets, and leave the big lock on. But you know that gets into a lot of issues with, you know, ground clearance, because you might end up crushing your rover and just damaging your vessel. I mean, you see, I've taken some damage on my trip out from Morph's Desert. I'd already offloaded the supplies and from the Constitution wreck out that way. I think we're gonna pull that in. So yeah, it's a very big. Oh yeah, I forgot exactly another one thing. I really need to just. There we go. Last engine. The last forward-facing engine set. So that way it has the same acceleration on all vectors except straight up. In fact, another thing that you could say I rightfully did forget is doing these as well. That way the thrust back down is a little more controlled than just stalling the big engines. So, yeah, I think we're ready. I just need to group the atmospheric thrusters that are already there. Decrease friction, increase damping, decrease damping, you get the idea. And occasionally I do have cause to fiddle with strength. Take this out for the same kind of spin we just had the other one out on. Thank you. You can conquer this because your twin sitting on the ice already did. As you can see, it likes bouncing. Alright, let's go. Maybe I haven't given it a little too much spring. Maybe it's a little too much, not enough shock. Now you get an idea of what kind of terrain this thing can conquer once you've actually gotten a feel for it. You know, rocks aren't even an issue, as long as you're hitting them right. Yeah, you can still easily blow one of the wheels off, or even two of the wheels off. And the empty frame itself is a lot more, Here's exactly why there's the jump jets. So you come across a bunch of gorges like that, you can still take them at speed just by jumping them. Not intended to be the primary mode of travel, but enough that, you know, unless you've got an extreme amount of stuff going on, that... make egress off the new model. Alright, well, I hope you guys enjoyed and that you... Oh yeah, I did lock it down. I'm shocked, actually. I forgot to lock it down one time and, as you can see, there's some damage here. I think it might have locked itself down or something. I don't know. But yeah, there's some damage on the drone because I forgot to lock it down, whereas I've not had the issue with this one because every time I've used it, I've locked it down. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'm going to be placing just the bare frame, and I'm going to actually... there we are. The bare frame itself for the... Rift for it on the workshop, and let's see. And it will come with a single battery mounted on it. As you can see, the empty frame itself is a bit less controllable. It likes having some weight on it. However, if you wanted to try to turn it into some sort of racing frame, that would be awesome. I'd like to see that. I might might actually use this and turn it into some sort of a large ship defense rover that you can, you know, just drive around your base, and it's got like 15 turrets on it. A flak rover. Hey, that might be an idea. I'm gonna do that. And that's how you get on the pad. Alright, well, I will see you guys around.